Another beautiful morning, guys. It is 7 o'clock, or at least this is what my clock shows. I don't know if there are any time differences here in this region, but it doesn't matter. I slept like a baby, everything was great. So it is time to head to Pokhara. No traffic, good. Me and sunrise again. Just filled the tank. The petrol is exactly $1. Nice, huh? Nice, huh? After hot, dusty India, this is just like a paradise. It is around 20 degrees, green everywhere, sunrise, excellent, excellent. Road is very good. I don't know how it's further, but this section here is excellent. This actually is a Royal Bardia National Park. So this is another one check post in the park, Bardia Park. So when I stop and went there, they asked me where you come from, Bulgaria. Okay, go. They don't even want to check my passport. Another one village on the road. Okay, let's see what they are watching. Ah, crocodiles. You see the croc there? It's totally different here. Totally different. So they don't even stop me on that checkpoint. There's many, many small houses and farms like this here. Very poor life. I guess they depend 100% from their land. Whatever they have in the land, the same they're gonna eat. So I can see fields everywhere. We are this guy and the goat on the top of the van. I don't know if I'm able to see it because of the light. Man. Actually, I need some place to eat. Maybe I can buy some fruits. Look at these ladies, how they carry the weight on their heads. Okay, I'll eat bananas. They all are preparing for Nepali festival. See how they paint the goat with this red color. So there will be, you see the kids, they already have clothes. All right, ate 3 bananas. Let's go. I cannot really afford to waste my time because I need to get to Pokhara, where I believe that I will be able to draw some money, local money. Because here, as you can see, no chance. No chance. I haven't seen anything about cash machines. Maybe they have, but maybe not, and with my European cards will be challenge. That's why I prefer to get to Pokhara. So this is actually the first information sign I have seen in Nepal. Okay, Butwal, I need Butwal. Straight. And the first roundabout I have seen. With people, alright. Oh, there is another one. Very big. Kathmandu 492, Butwal 236. Alright. So this must be a big town. I miss the name because in most of the places at the beginning of the town they have a big sign, but on Nepali. Now from 20 minutes I've got this beautiful road, maybe from 30 minutes. Pretty roads around the mountains. It's green, you can see the green background. Nice. Simple village. big town. Let's see if I can find ATM here. Not really. Okay. So after I spent more than 250 kilometers today, and maybe 70-80 miles, that means about 350 kilometers from the border, I start to see signs, hotels, hostels, restaurants, on written on with Latin letters. Before that was only like this. Interesting. So I will ride more 50 kilometers and then we'll stop to eat something until I get to 300. Then I will know that I have more than half of the road. I can stop for half an hour to eat something and then continue. Another one big town. Which way? Pokhara. This way or this way? I need to ask. Hey, Pokhara? Pokhara?
Where are you going?
Pokhara?
Pokhara? Where are you coming?
That way.
Which village? Where are you come from here?
I want to go to Pokhara.
Yeah, you go to Pokhara?
This way or that way?
This way.
This way?
Oh, yeah.
Okay.
Where are you going?
Pokhara.
Pokhara. I will
Okay, good. It's not that I don't want to wait, but they always start with questions. Where are you from? What you do? And stuff like that. That's why I just go. It's green now from everywhere. The road now is not that good, a lot of potholes. It's still okay. Where is the village? I just asked about the directions again because I was not sure, but all good, I'm on the right way. Okay, it is time to eat something. Let's see what can I find here. Hi. Hi. Hello.
Namaste.
Namaste. I want to eat something. All right. Everything was good. I ate for $2. rice and some vegetables. All right, it's time to move. I have more about 40 kilometers to Butovel, and from there I'll turn left to Pokhara. Some people suggest the road through Palpa or something like that, but unfortunately I cannot find this road. My map is not very detailed and there is no information. So I cannot really find this road. Alright, so this is Butovel. Now I need to find the turn to Pokhara. It's a big town. No information, no signs, no nothing. Again, I need to stop and ask. So I asked already, this is the direction of Pokhara. The best person to ask are usually these rickshaw guys, because they like taxis, so they know what they do. Oh, this is big city. So actually this is the biggest I have seen so far. Why should I wait? So, accidentally, I found a road through Palpa. Alright, good. So this is the road which one was recommended to me. Ah, beautiful. Alright. This is nice, huh? Unfortunately, the beginning was really, really bad. I really hope that it will improve later, because it was just a gravel road with a lot of potholes and a lot of bushes and dust. So now here it's improved a bit. Let's see what is going to be after that. So unfortunately sections like that will be always on the road, so I have to be careful, of course, as usual, safety first. It is around 150 kilometers to Pokhara or Pokhara, whatever the name is, and I plan to stay there, and maybe we'll stay one more day. We'll see what I can see there once I get, but first I need to get there. And as you can see, the condition of the road, it's not something to underestimate. It is readable, it's not a problem to ride it, but it is a slow road. So when exactly I'll be there, what time I'm going to have, I don't know. Let's get there first and then we'll talk. Okay. Of course I have to keep in mind that people cut the corners and stunt on the corners. It's a combination of many obstacles. Which one makes this road somehow dangerous? It is not a technical road, but because of the things I just said, it could be very, very dangerous. That's why, slowly, safety first. And until now I have 360 kilometers. It is 2 o'clock in the afternoon. I hope in about 3 hours maximum I'll be in Pokhara. If everything is okay, of course, with God will. Himalaya, as usual, doing everything absolutely wonderful. The road down there from India border up to here was nothing really to enjoy, with one big difference that since I entered Nepal, everything became green. So it's not like India, like all burned from the sun. It is green, it is not that hot. It's around 25 degrees at the moment, which is good. And that's it. I really hope that I will see some beautiful spot to stop for a while and just show with the camera. But let's see. All right.